Hello, this is Roger with Google. This recording is a getting started using Google Slides on Microsoft Windows with the NVDA Screen Reader and the Firefox browser. In this recording, I will describe the major sections of the application, how to move between those sections, how to read a slide deck, how to insert a slide into an existing deck, how to modify a slide, and how to get additional information. Let's get started. I had previously navigated to drive.google.com. Now let's go find the slide deck that I want to open up and use today. I'm going to do a down arrow.
Stuff Google Drive folder owned by me, last modified by me, September 4th. Folders do not take up quota space 2 of 7.
I'm going to press enter to go into this folder.
Folder list, viewed list. Vacation planning shared Google Slides owned by me, last modified by me, October 8th. Google Slides files do not take up quota space not selected 1 of 4.
I'm going to press X to select this file.
Selected.
Now I'm going to press enter to open this file.
You are online. Screen reader support enabled. Vacation planning dash Google Slides busy.
I press the control key to silence the verbalization. You may have noticed during that verbalization, it did say that screen reader support is enabled. I've already done the one-time setup to enable screen reader support in the Slides, Sheets, and Docs applications. To find more about enabling the screen reader mode, listen to the Getting Started Using Google Docs recording. The Slides application consists of these major sections. First is the canvas area, which is information about an individual slide. The film strip area, which is a list of all the slides within your slide deck. Speaker notes area, which is notes about a particular slide. A top toolbar and a main toolbar. And finally, there is a context menu that you can also open up. To get to the application menu, you press Alt, Shift, and another letter like F as in file, O as in format, I as in insert. I'm going to go ahead and press Alt, Shift, F now.
File submenu 1 of 11.
Once you are in the application menu, you can use the up and down arrow keys to go through submenu items. I'm going to do down arrow a couple times.
Share, yes, Emil, 1 of 1. New, hence Emil, submenu 1 of 7.
You can also use the left and right arrow keys to move through the application menu.
Document 1 of 6. Edit submenu 2 of 11. Viewed submenu 3 of 11.
To activate a menu item, press Enter, or you can press Escape to return back to your slide deck. I'm going to press Escape now.
Document region.
To go to the top toolbar, first go to the application menu by pressing Alt, Shift, F.
File submenu 1 of 11.
Then do a Shift tab to go to the top toolbar.
Share. Shared with 3 people. Button.
Then continue pressing Shift tab to go through the rest of the top toolbar. Or, if you've gone too far, you can press Tab to go backwards. I'm going to press Escape to return back to the slide deck.
Document region. Weissenweg:.
I press Control to silence the verbalization. To go to the main toolbar, first go to the application menu by pressing Alt-Shift-F.
File submenu 1 of 11.
Then press the Tab key twice.
Last edit was main toolbar. New slide left paren shortcut Control plus M right paren button.
Use the left and right arrow keys to go through the other items in the main toolbar. I'm now going to press Escape to go back to the slide deck.
Vacation planning dash Google slide.
I press Control to silence the output. The main area does consist of the film strip, the canvas, and the speaker notes. To go to the canvas area, press Control Alt Shift C as in canvas.
Canvas.
To go to the speaker notes, press Control Alt Shift S as in speaker notes.
Speaker notes, enter text selection.
To go to the film strip, press Control Alt Shift F as in film strip.
Film strip slide 1 of 4, planning the vacation things to consider layout : title slide to objects on the page selected.
To open the context menu, you press Control Shift X as in x-ray. I'm going to do so now.
Menu submenu.
And then you would use the up and down arrow keys to go through the context menu.
Cut shortcut Control plus X 1 of 3. Copy shortcut Control plus C 2 of 3.
I'm going to press Escape to return back to the film strip.
Weissenweg:\0.
I press Control to silence the output. Once you're on the film strip, if you press the up and down arrow keys, you'll go from slide to slide. As you do so, the content of the slide is verbalized. I'm going to press the down arrow now so you can listen to slide 2.
Slide 2 of 4, type what type of vacation : bullet relics bullet adventure bullet family visit bullet community service layout : title and body to objects on the page selected.
I'm going to press down arrow again.
Slide 3 for transportation, how to get there : bullet air bullet rail bullet car bullet bus bullet other layout : title and body to objects on the page selected.
I might do down arrow again.
Slide 4 of 4. Lodging where to say bullet. Hotel bullet. Resort bullet. Family bullet. Friends bullet. Other layout colon. Title and body to objects on the page selected.
That was slide 4 of 4, so there's no more slides to go through. I'm going to press the up arrow to go back to slide 1.
Slide 3 of 4. Transportation. How to get there colon. Bullet air bullet trip. Slide 2 of 4. Slide 1 of 4. Planning the vacation things to consider layout colon. Title.
I press Control to silence the output. I'm going to go to the speaker notes by pressing Control Alt Shift S as in speaker notes.
Speaker notes, enter text selection.
To read the speaker notes, you do a combination of down arrow and up arrow. So I'm going to do a down arrow, followed by an up arrow to read the first line of the speaker notes.
This slide deck is an example deck used for the getting started recording.
I'm going to do a down arrow again. So that's all the speaker notes we have in this one. Now I'm going to return back to the film strip by pressing Control Alt Shift F as in film strip.
Film strip slide 1 of 4 planning the...
I press Control to silence the output. Now I'm going to go to slide 2.
Slide 2 of 4 type what type of vacation colon. Bullet relics bullet adventure.
I press Control to silence the output. Now I want to again go back to the speaker notes by pressing Control Alt Shift S.
Speaker notes enter text selection.
I'm going to do a down arrow, then an up arrow to read the speaker notes that's here.
Here are some speaker notes.
I'm going to do a down arrow. So in the speaker notes, you simply just start typing to add or replace any of the speaker notes that's there. So I'm going to add another line. I'm going to do an up arrow to read the content that I'm going to do an up arrow to read the line that I just typed in.
This is a second flag unit of speaker notes.
Yeah, it sounds like there's actually a spelling error there. I'm going to use the control right arrow to explore this in more detail.
Is a second misspelling line unit.
Yep, and indeed there was. So now I'm going to go ahead and correct this by using the suggestions that's available within Docs. To get to the suggestions, open up the context menu by pressing Control Shift X as an X-ray.
Menu, submenu.
Down arrow.
Spelling suggestion colon. Line 2 of 2.
I'm going to press Enter to accept.
Wise awake colon flash flash.
I press Control to silence the output. Now I'm going to do a down arrow and up arrow to reread this line.
This is a second line of speaker notes.
Now that does sound correct. Now I'm going to move the focus to the canvas by pressing Control Alt Shift C as in canvas.
Canvas.
When you're on the canvas, it consists of multiple objects. And you move between the objects by pressing the tab key. I'm going to do so now.
Title type selected.
I'm going to press tab again.
Body what type of vacation colon. Bullet relics bullet adventure bullet family visit bullet community service selected.
I'm going to press tab again.
Title type selected.
So wrap back around to the type. So in this slide, there's only two objects. I'm going to press tab again to go to the body.
Body what type of vacation colon. Bullet relics bullet adventure.
I press control to silence the output. If you want to read the content of an object or make changes within an object, you first need to go into edit mode by pressing enter. I'm going to do so now.
What type of vacation colon? Bullet relics bullet advent.
I press control key to silence the output. Now you can use the up and down arrow keys to read through the content of the object. I'm going to do so now.
What type of vacation colon? Bullet relics bullet advent. Bullet relics. Bullet adventure. Bullet family visit. Bullet community service.
So community service is the last one. I'm going to press N to go to the end of this line. Now I'm going to press enter to create another type of vacation.
Bullet. Up, B. Up. R slash. V, A, C. I, O, N.
I'm not going to go ahead and press enter because if I do, then that'll create another bullet item. So I'm going to do an up arrow and then a down arrow to read this content.
Bullet community service. Bullet combo work slash vacation.
Now I'm going to press Escape to go back into the slide navigation mode.
Exited text selection body. What type of vacation colon?
I press Control key to silence the output. When you're in slide navigation mode, if you press the arrow keys, that will move the object that currently has focused. I'm going to do so now.
Nudged up by 0.083 inches.
If you didn't want to do that, you do a Control Z to undo. I'm going to do so now.
Undo.
When you're on the canvas, you can also use the page up and page down keys to move to other slides. I'm going to press the page down now.
Change to slide 3.
I'm going to do page down again.
Change to slide 4.
Now I want to insert another slide into the slide deck. I'm going to do so by first opening up the Insert menu by pressing Alt-Shift-I.
Insert submenu 4 of 11.
I'm going to do a down arrow until I get to New Slide.
Text box. Base email 1 of 10. Image. Vice email 3 of 10. Video. Vice email 5 of 10. Word art. W semi 6 of 10. Line. L semi. Submenu 7 of 10. Shape. S email. Submenu 8 of 10. Table. Vice email. Submenu 9 of 10. Comment. M email. Shortcut control plus. New slide. Hands email. Shortcut control plus M 1 of 2.
Now I'm going to press Enter to insert the new slide.
Inserted slide at index 5 with layout title and body. Weiss & Wade:// 0/.
I press Control to silence the output. Now I'm going to press Control Alt Shift C to move to the canvas.
Canvas.
I'm going to press Tab to get to the title of the slide.
Title selected.
I'm going to press Enter to go into edit mode.
Enter text selection.
Now I'm going to type in Agenda. I'm going to press Escape to go back to slide navigation mode.
Exited text selection. Title agenda selected.
I'm going to press Tab to go to the body.
Body selected.
Now I'm going to press Enter to go into edit mode.
Enter text selection.
Now I'm going to type in the name of the other slides in the slide deck. I'm going to do an up arrow to review what I've typed in.
Lodging.
Up arrow again.
Transportation.
Up arrow again.
Type of vacation.
For this slide, these would actually be better if they were bullets. So I want to change these to a bullet by pressing Control-Shift-8.
Created bulleted list with one item.
I'm going to do down arrow to go to the next item.
Transportation.
Again, I'm going to do Control-Shift-8.
Added items to list.
Down arrow again.
Lodging.
And again, do Control-Shift-8.
Added items to list.
If I'd wanted this to be a numbered list, I would have typed in Control-Shift-7. I'm now going to press Escape to exit edit mode and go back to slide navigation mode.
Exited text selection. Body bullet. Type of vacation bullet. Transportation.
I press Control key to silence the output. I'm going to move focus to the film strip.
Film strip. Slide 5. The 5 agenda bullet. Type of vacation.
I press Control key to silence the output. This new slide is called Agenda, but having it at the end of the slide deck is not a great place for it. We want to move this up to position 2. To move a slide, you press Control and the up or down arrow keys. And I'm going to press Control up arrow now.
Move slides to index 4.
Again.
Move slides to index 3.
Again.
Move slides to index 2.
If you're on the film strip, you can move focus to the canvas by using the Control Alt Shift C shortcut, or you can also just press Tab.
Title agenda selected.
Another way that you can access items within the application menu is to do a search the application menu. To do a search, press Alt///
Search the menus left paren alt plus slash right paren combo box collapsed has autocomplete editable blank.
Now type in text for what you want to search for. In this case, I want to search for slide.
Fifth list. List item. New slide shortcut control plus M 1 of 10.
In this case, it came up with 10 results, and the first one was new slide. So this is another way that you can create a new slide by just simply pressing Enter now, or press the down arrow to explore the other results.
Duplicate slide 2 of 10. Delete slide 3 of 10. Change theme. 4 of 10. Change transition. 5 of 10. Move slide up shortcut control plus up. 6 of 10. Move slide down shortcut control plus down. 7 of 10. Move slide to beginning shortcut control plus shift plus up. 8. Move slide to end shortcut control plus shift plus down. Next slide shortcut page down.
So that's all the results. Now I'm going to press Escape.
Weiss & Wade://
Google Slides has many shortcuts. To get a list of the shortcuts, press Control/ to bring up the shortcut dialog. I might do so now.
Keyboard shortcuts dialog.
Now you will want to move NVDA into browse mode by pressing NVDA plus the spacebar.
Keyboard shortcuts dialog heading level 2 keyboard.
I press Control to silence the output. Now I want to move the focus to the table of shortcuts, so I'm going to type T.
Table with 79 rows and 2 columns. Popular keyboard shortcuts dialog.
Now I'm going to press the down arrow a few times so you can hear the first few shortcuts.
Row 1, column 1, heading level 3 with slides. Column 2. Row 2 with slides, column 1, new slide. column to control plus M. Row 3 with slides, column 1 duplicate slide, column to control plus D.
I'm going to press escape to return back to the slide deck.
Weiss wait colon slash flat.
I press control to silence the output. Google also has online documentation. You can find it a couple of different ways. One is to do a Google search for Get Started with Google Slides Using a Screen Reader, or you can go to google.com/accessible, where you'll find information on this product and many other products, as well as links to our online documentation. Thanks for listening, and I hope you found this recording useful.
This work is licensed under a Creative Commons Attribution 4.0 international license, which can be found at http://creativecommons.org/licenses/by/4.0/. You are free to share, copy, and redistribute this material in any medium or format.